Hi everyone, my name is Lavina. I'm one of your youth leaders and I just want to say welcome to FNL. Welcome to our online service. I promise you this is not how we usually do things and we're going to go back to normal services hopefully soon. We miss you and we want to see you in person. But if this is your very first time joining in, I just want to say hi and welcome. And I'll meet you in person soon. You can text me and then we can talk then. But you can ask your group leader or ask your friend who brings you into like the small group later on, ask the leader to go check you a bang bang. Or if you're like more creative, ask them to go check you a Starbucks or a Kopi Kenangan or whatever. But just ask them to go check you something to welcome you, okay? So we're so excited to have you here. And I hope you're so excited, even though we're not kind of like seeing one another in person. We don't get to see Fish in person or me or the leaders. But I hope you're so pumped to be in the small groups later on and then to just be together online, okay? I hope you're all healthy too. And tonight, we're kicking off a new, I wouldn't say sermon series, because probably it's not as long as a sermon, but like a series, like a devotional series that's titled Unshakeable. Okay? Unshakeable. Okay, with that, I hope you're ready, but we're going to open it with a word of prayer. Okay? Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you so much, God, for this time to be together. Lord, thank you so much for being the one thing that is constant in the midst of all of this uncertainty. Lord, thank you for being the God who is unfailing, whose hope we can hold on to. And Lord, tonight as we talk about unshakable faith, Lord, I just pray that you will do the necessary work in our hearts, God, so that we may see you and experience you. Lord, wherever we are, in our homes, in our bedrooms, God, in our living rooms, wherever we are right now, we just ask that your presence, God, will be evident. That you will touch hearts and that you will somehow create a sense of peace and of recognition that you are still who you say you are. Thank you, Father. Bless your word tonight and we welcome you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, so the word unshakable means you can't really get rid of it. Okay, it means it's firm. You cannot move it. It's unchanging. It's so strong that you can't destroy it. It cannot be altered. Okay? But you don't know whether something is unshakable or not until you actually try to shake it off of its foundation. Like if it stays as it is, like you don't really know. You don't know how strong it is until you try to contest it. Now, one of the great tests of you know, durability and of strength is actually the test of time. Like the test of time is great because waiting is not fun, right? I want you to imagine this. So you're after a basketball practice and you're really thirsty. You're in the supermarket, right? You're queuing. You want to buy one bottle of water that's really cold. But then in front of you, there's like two aunties with two full shopping carts. And the mba who is at the cashier, you know, is like, beep. Beep, you know, and you're just standing there and you're like, will this waiting ever be over? And that's waiting. And then you might be texting, you texted a girl that you really like, you know, like one of you boys, maybe you're in there, and then it's been an hour later and she hasn't replied. And you're like, you know, that waiting period is just excruciating. Right? So you get this, like waiting is not easy. But waiting with hardship is even more difficult. So this is like, to stay hopeful and joyful in this situation is something that is really challenging for a lot of us. Now, let me introduce you to a character in the Bible named Joseph. This character is special because he had unshakable faith in the waiting and in the midst of hardships. Now, God showed Joseph his calling and a dream when he was 17. You can read it in Genesis 37. I'm not going to read to you the whole thing. You can read it at home. But in the dream, Joseph saw that he was going to rule. He saw it in his dream. That he was called for something big. And it came true. It really did. Because Joseph became the second most powerful man in Egypt. He basically governed the country. He ruled over it. He He was a powerful man, and he was so impactful. But that was when he was 30 years old. He received a vision when he was 17. So he was 17 and he was 30 when he became second in command. And this gap was a very long waiting period. It was around 13 years of waiting. Now, in this waiting, it wasn't all the fun. If you read his entire story, like Joseph was hated by his siblings, you know, he was eventually thrown into like a really deep well. And I had to Google how to actually say this, which is cistern. I never say it out loud, cistern, you know. So he was thrown into it. He was sold into slavery. He was bullied. He was framed, thrown into prison. He was forgotten by his friends. Like, these are literally not fun things. We do not want to go through some of these things. But in this waiting period that is full of disappointment and then question and confusion, Joseph remained unshakable in his faith in God. So tonight, I just want to share to you like three quick lessons, like what does an unshakable faith look like when we live it out? And the first thing is that you keep going. You keep going. Okay, so let me give you a bit of perspective. Did Joseph like being sold into slavery? Did he like being bullied by his boss's wife? Did he enjoy being in prison? Now, if I were you, my answer would be, no, of course not. We don't like that. This is not a season that was ideal or enjoyable on paper, but Joseph kept going. Joseph lived it as if that was the main thing, that was the season that he was not in waiting. Like, if we read through the whole story, like, Joseph's boss, like Potiphar, he really liked Joseph because Joseph did a great job in handling his household, taking care of this and that and everything, which means Joseph was responsible. And then when he was in prison, he was literally in prison. And yet he was made responsible over everybody there, which meant Joseph was not like sitting around crying and then sleeping away all his sorrows, but he was so focused on doing a good job in wherever he is. And that's the mentality. You keep going. Even if his current season doesn't look like the season that he wants to be in. Now, what do we do in the waiting? Do you just, like, I'm not saying that it's not okay to cry. It's okay if you need to cry and be angry and frustrated and disappointed and feel like it's not right. But what I'm saying is, we gotta keep going. There's work to be done. We gotta keep serving and loving and praying and staying hopeful and keep encouraging one another. This is what unshakable faith looks like. See, we have to believe it. The Bible tells us this, that whatever we do for God is never useless. So if we keep praying and we keep serving, God sees that, and that's never gonna go to waste. It's not a pause. I want to tell you, it's not a pause. It is the exact, you are exactly where you need to be. And then the second lesson is that you don't compromise. See, not only do we keep serving God, but we make sure we don't bend our values. Joseph experienced a time where he was so bullied and he was pressured, and he could just give in when sin was in front of the door. You can read the story like on Potiphar, like we call her Tante Potiphar, right? Like Potiphar's wife, the boss's wife, was trying to get Joseph to convince him to commit a sin, but then Joseph ran. See, for us, it's so easy in times of trouble for us to just bend our values and then give in to sin and stop honoring God altogether because we don't see the fruit. But I want to encourage you that when we look at Joseph's life, he did not do that. He honored God. And he stood strong in what he believed in the truths and the commands of God. And that's why, even though in reality, by him saying no to Aunt Potiphar, he was thrown to prison, but God showed favor upon him, and then he was fine in prison, and he was even set as the number one man in prison. So this is a beautiful story of how not compromising. When we honor God, God sees it and God rewards us. And then finally, like, the last lesson that we can take from Joseph's life is that you don't have to go through it alone. You just don't. What made Joseph stood out from everybody else was not his good works, was not him good looking. you know, obviously, like, because Aunt Potiphar wanted him, he was good looking, probably. But that wasn't it. But throughout Genesis, you can see that at least four times it says, the Lord was with Joseph. There was a special anointing and favor upon Joseph's life that blessed Potiphar's household, that blessed and people in prison. And eventually it blessed Pharaoh and Egypt and all people of Israel. See, the Bible teaches us that when we look for God wholeheartedly and we want Him more than anything else, He will not disappoint us. And I really believe that God's presence in our lives, it sets us apart. It makes it different. The fruit of what we do is different because God's presence is there. And this is what happens with Joseph. Now, Joseph was unshakable in his pursuit of God and dependence on God. That is why, as a result, God's presence was also unshakable in Joseph's life. Now, this truth alone should give us like a sense of assurance, because if God is with us, even though we're stepping into an unknown and even though we're in the waiting and we cannot see this, the end, we are with a God who sees the end already and who goes before us. Now, if we read through Joseph's story, see, Joseph's story is a story of hardship. It's the story of a man who holds on to a promise and who refuses to let go, even though what he sees is not the same. Faith is like that. I remember Valerie did a message a few years ago where he taught us, like, faith is what we cannot see. When you put a blindfold upon our circumstance, and we still walk, and we still love, and we still hope, because we know that our faith is not by sight. And this is what Joseph did. Now, for some of us, we get this because we're not at the end. We get this because you are in the waiting. You're praying for a sick family and they're not well yet. You are in a grieving season and you cannot see when is this going to end. Like, for some of us, we've been praying for the salvation of a loved one and we're not seeing the results of it yet. But I want to encourage you, Joseph saw the end, a preview of it, when he was 17. But he lived out a life that was almost the complete opposite of what God promises. But he stayed put. He stuck around. He was unshakable in what he believed. And at the end of it, he saw God's promises come into full fruition. I want to encourage you tonight. Are you in that waiting? And are you asking, is God really there? Because we have two choices of how we can respond. And first, we waver and we walk away and we forget all of it together. Or we remain unshakable. Because the same God who is faithful to Joseph is the same God that we serve. The same God who answers Joseph's prayers after 13 years of waiting and let it come into full fruition is the same God that we serve today. I want to tell you that His hope is still unfailing. There is still victory that is ahead, and His promises and His calling is worth waiting for. Are you willing to give God a chance to prove to you that He is who He says He is? And are you willing to try to live out this unshakable faith, believing that it's not going to go to vain and that God is going to prove Himself once again in your life? I want to close with this verse, Philippians 1, verse 6. It says that, I'm certain that God who began the good work within you will continue His work until it is finally finished on the day when Christ Jesus returns. This on its own is a promise then you can hold on to, because I know God loves you so much. God is not done. And I know it seems weird that we're recording this and I'm crying on camera right now. But I believe that this is a message that is for somebody listening to this video right now. God is not done, and God is not finished with your story, and God is just getting started. So I want to encourage you and challenge you that perhaps Joseph's story is exactly what you need to hear tonight. And with that, allow me to pray for you. And I just want to invite all of the group leaders to just come together and begin to pray for all of your group members. Let's pray tonight. Lord, I just want to pray for everyone who's listening, Lord, from their homes and their living rooms, God, and whatever circumstance that they're going through, God. Lord, we might not see each other face to face right now, and I can't even put, you know, my hand maybe on their heads and stuff, and the group leaders, and we're all just virtually connected. But I believe that your presence goes beyond space and time and goes beyond, like, the limitations of four walls. Lord, I just ask that you will touch hearts. As they listen to this message, God, may the message of Philippians 1, verse 6, and may the message of Joseph, God, be an encouragement to all of us that you are just getting started. Lord, that you're going to do some amazing things if we stick around. Thank you for being the God that we can hold on to. Thank you for being the God who is faithful. And we celebrate you tonight. Lord, bless our discussions in our groups, and we pray that tonight is just the beginning of crazy, amazing breakthroughs that you want to do in us. Thank you so much, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a wonderful time in your group. We miss you, we love you, and we'll see you again next week. Bye.